It's AumSum time!
What if Batman disappeared?
No problem. Like Batman, even I am not scared of anybody. Oh, AumSum. To buy AumSum merchandise, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, if Batman disappeared, Joker would be the happiest villain in town. Secondly, if Batman disappeared, Batwoman might come to the rescue. Thirdly, if Batman disappeared, the famous Batmobile will only be visible in museums now. Fourthly, if Batman disappeared, people who were afraid of bats will be one happy lot. Fifthly, if Batman disappeared, Robin will dearly miss his senior partner while solving complex cases. Lastly, if Batman disappeared, streets of Gotham City will not be that safe anymore. How do glasses work?
They work very hard to make us look intelligent and studious.
No.
When light from an object reaches our eyes, the cornea and lens refract the light. In a person having perfect vision, the refracted light is accurately focused on the retina. The retina then sends information to the brain, informing it about the object. However, in some people, the light does not get properly focused on the retina, causing blurry vision. When light gets focused before the retina, the defect is called myopia. Myopia can be corrected using glasses having concave lenses. Whereas, when light gets focused behind the retina, the defect is called hyperopia or hypermetropia. Hypermetropia can be corrected using glasses having convex lenses. Apart from these, there are other defects also like presbyopia and astigmatism, which can also be corrected using glasses having appropriate lenses.
How do nails grow?
A nail consists of many different parts. The visible part of the nail is called nail plate. Nail plate lies on the nail bed.
Can I sleep on that bed?
Oh, just listen. Matrix is the area where nail growth originates. It lies below the skin. Matrix has specialized cells which keep dividing and creating nail cells. The nail cells grow and produce a hard protein called keratin. Then, these keratin-filled cells are pushed forward as more new cells are formed behind them. Eventually, the keratin-filled cells die and flatten to form the nail plate. The hard keratin in these dead cells gives strength to the nail and makes it hard.
But what is the use of these nails?
Nails protect our fingertips. Moreover, by observing the condition of our nails, doctors can get clues about our overall health. Why is glass transparent?
Give me minimum 5 years to unravel its mystery.
Alright, now listen. Any substance is said to be transparent when particles of visible light called photons are not absorbed by the substance and thus they easily pass through the substance. However, if the photons get absorbed, then the substance is said to be opaque.
But why do some substances absorb photons while others don't?
Whether a substance will absorb the photons or not depends upon the gaps present in between the orbits of electrons of that substance. If the gaps in a substance are small, then the electrons of that substance are able to absorb the photons which pass through those gaps, making the substance opaque. However, in glass, the gaps are big. Hence, most of the photons do not get absorbed. They easily pass through those gaps, making glass transparent. What causes wrinkles?
A witch's potion.
Nah. Our skin consists of two important proteins called collagen and elastin. Collagen keeps our skin firm and tight, while elastin gives our skin flexibility and elasticity. It allows our skin to stretch, twist, and contract.
Just like an elastic rubber band, right?
Absolutely. But as we age, our skin produces less collagen and elastin. Hence, our skin no longer remains firm. It begins to lose elasticity. As a result, our skin droops, thus causing wrinkles. Moreover, there are some factors that can cause early wrinkling. One of them is UV radiation of the sun. Long-term exposure to UV radiation can cause collagen and elastin to break down faster than normal, thus causing wrinkles in early age. Besides this, smoking and poor nutrition may also contribute to early wrinkling. How do igloos keep you warm?
I'm a little busy, so I'll tell you later.
All right, I'll explain. Heat is a form of energy present in our body. When the temperatures around us are low, we begin to lose heat. The more we lose heat, the colder we feel. Now, although igloos are made up of blocks of compressed snow, they keep us warm.
Oh, stop bluffing. How's that possible?
Compressed snow has air trapped in it, and air is a bad conductor of heat. Hence, the heat given off by our body does not get lost from the igloo. It stays in the igloo, thus keeping us warm. Besides this, we know that warm air rises up and cold air sinks to the bottom. Hence, during night, Eskimos, that is, people living in igloos, sleep at the uppermost part of the igloo to stay warm. What is an allergy?
It is a magic spell!
No. Allergy is an overreaction of our immune system to usually harmless substances like peanuts, milk, pollen, etc. These substances are called allergens. Our immune system has white blood cells, or lymphocytes, which protect us from foreign invaders such as bacteria, viruses, parasites, etc. These invaders are called antigens. When a lymphocyte detects an antigen, it produces antibodies. Antibodies destroy antigens and thus protect us. Now, if an allergen such as pollen is inhaled by an allergic person, the lymphocytes of the allergic person, for unknown reasons, think that the allergen is an antigen. Hence, lymphocytes overreact and produce antibodies, which start attacking the allergen. Besides this, as a protective response, some immune cells also trigger production of excess mucus, resulting in running nerves. They even give rise to itching throat and watery eyes, thus causing an allergy. What is a stroke?
It is a new style of haircut.
No. Through a complex system of arteries, our brain gets a continuous supply of oxygen and nutrients with the help of blood. The cells of our brain alone use more than 20% of oxygen in our blood. Hence, if the blood doesn't reach the brain cells, they can begin to die, thus giving us a stroke. The most common stroke is ischemic stroke. Ischemic strokes occur when the arteries supplying blood to the brain get blocked.
Like the roads get blocked in a traffic jam, right?
Indeed. Due to bad lifestyle choices and stress, fats and cholesterol gradually start building up in the arteries and thus narrow them. If this buildup ruptures, a clot may form blocking the complete artery. As a result, the brain cells begin to die due to lack of oxygen and nutrients, thus giving us an ischemic stroke. What is a tardigrade?
I don't know.
A tardigrade is one of the smallest animals. It can grow only about 1 millimeter or less in length. However, it is the toughest animal in the whole world.
Ha! It cannot be tougher than me.
Alright, now listen. Scientists say that tardigrades can survive in extremely inhospitable environments.
But how?
When the environment is inhospitable, the tardigrades enter a state called cryptobiosis. In cryptobiosis, they curl up into a ball-like structure called tongue. All their metabolic processes almost stop. In this state, tardigrades can survive in about minus 459 degrees Fahrenheit and even in about 300 degrees Fahrenheit. They can live deep in the oceans and withstand the huge pressure of water. They can even survive in the vacuum of space and can withstand radiation. Later, when the conditions are stable, they again come back to their normal form. Why don't spiders stick to their webs?
I don't know.
Usually, a spider's web is made up of silk threads which are covered with droplets of glue. This glue makes the thread sticky. Now, when an insect flies through the web, the insect normally gets stuck to the sticky thread. But a spider does not get stuck because its legs have tiny hair-like structures called cilia. When a spider walks on a sticky thread, the cilia gets stuck onto the thread, helping the spider to get grip and support to walk. Now, as the point of contact is very less, the glue has very less surface area to stick. Hence, the spider easily pulls its legs without sticking. Besides this, a research suggests that certain spiders' legs are covered with a special chemical coating. This coating also helps the legs from sticking to the glue.
Hmm.